गुड आफ्टरनून डियर लर्नर एंड वेलकम बैक टू दिस टेलीकॉन्फ्रेंसिंग सेशन एंड द टॉपिक फॉर द टेलीकॉन्फ्रेंसिंग इज इन्वेंट्री कंट्रोल विच इज मेंट फॉर द बीकॉम स्टूडेंट दैट इज ईसीओ 10 एलिमेंट्स ऑफ कॉस्टिंग. सो लर्नर व्हेन वी टॉक regarding inventory control. So inventory, you know, sometimes what happens that we have to meet out so many exigencies. So in this era of cutthroat competition and in this era of complete uncertainties, we need to keep the amount of stock for the emergency purpose, or sometimes what happens that if we have been asked to meet out a huge demand of the product in the market, in that case we need to keep the amount of the inventory in surplus with us, so that our production process could not be hampered and we can contribute, we can produce, we can meet out the demand of the customer as per their satisfaction. So when learners, when we talk about inventory control, because sometimes when we are managing the inventories, we have to keep so many things into account. Say for example, we have to decide the maximum level of the inventory which should be available with the firm at all time. So what should be that maximum level? Because sometimes when we are keeping the amount of the inventory high, in that case it would unnecessarily block the funds in the unproductive exercise. So simultaneously we should also forecast the demand of the product, and accordingly we should keep the maximum level of the stock, otherwise it would completely be blocked in the unproductive exercise. And on the other hand, the minimum level of the stock, because once we are reached to that minimum level, we need to issue a fresh order to the supplier so that we can get the material from the supplier well in time, and by that time the amount of stock which we have with us, that minimum level, we can continue the production without any hamper. So there are so many issues. So in order to discuss these issues in detail, today we have Professor M.S.S. Raju, who is a very senior faculty, in fact he is a professor of commerce, and he will discuss all these issues in detail. So with these words, I hand over the session to Professor Raju to discuss these issues in detail. Sir.
Good afternoon to all the learners, and on behalf of me, welcome to the second session of today's teleconferencing. As Sunil said, the topic is on inventory control. So inventory control or material control, both are interchangeable. But inventory control is little bit a broader term. Normally when we say material, when we use the term material, it covers raw material and store supplies, then partly finished goods. That means the items which are used in the process to produce a product is normally we termed as materials. But why I said the inventory is a broader term, it covers raw material, store supplies, spare parts, partly finished goods, and finished goods also. So when we use material control or inventory control, it is same as. So now look at the definition of inventory control, which explains the meaning, definition, as well as the scope and coverage of the inventory control. If you look at the definition, inventory control is a systematic control and regulation of purchases. This should be underlined. One is regulation of purchases and regulation of stores and usage of materials in such a way so as to maintain a flow of production, at the same time avoiding excessive investment in inventories. This also should be underlined, that is, to maintain a flow of production at the same time avoiding excessive investment in inventories. Efficient material control cuts out losses and wastage of materials that otherwise passes unnoticed. So the objective of the material control is efficient material control cuts out the losses. That means the objective is to minimize the losses and use the inventory in effective way in the process of production. So here now we can put a question: what is the necessity? Why inventory control is required? This is a question. So if we can get the answer from this question, if we analyze the process of production. So in the process of production, there are various items has to be passed on: materials, material expenditure, labor, factory expenses, office expenses, selling and distribution expenses to arrive the cost of sales. So if we analyze the cost of production, the material component plays a major role in the cost of production. That means the material cost accounts a major component in the cost of production. We can say it, the cost may account 60 to sometimes 80% also. It ranges 60 and 80%. So the major objective of costing is to control wherever the high value costs involved in the process of production. Therefore, if the proper control is not exercised on material, there may be a possibility of incurring losses or not effectively utilizing the high value component, that is materials, in the process of production. So if there is a low supply of material, then there is a problem of low production, or sometimes the supply may be holding up. If there is an excess supply of material, or if there is excess storage of material, then there is a loss of obsolescence and incurring huge cost of material carrying cost or inventory carrying cost. Therefore, an effective management is required. An effective and systematic control is required on inventory. If you see the objectives of inventory control, for what purpose the inventory has to be controlled, or a scientific control exercise has to be applied for inventory. The objectives are: number one, continuous flow of inventory. If there is no continuous flow of inventory, then the production may be stopped. Sometimes the production may be disturbed. If production is disturbed, and various costs will goes waste. And second objective is avoid excessive investment in inventory. See, if we purchase the material more than the requirement, then there is a wastage of working capital. That means the working capital unnecessarily we have blocked. It can be, the working capital can be used somewhere. Therefore, to avoid excessive inventory, excessive investment on inventory. and minimize wastage. For example, if we purchase material more than the required quantity, then we have to store the material, and we have to keep the material at stores for longer period. Due to the passage of time, the material quality, the material may lose its basic features. And if the material loses its basic features, it means that the quality of material will go down. And if we use that material in the process of production, we may get the low quality of the product also sometimes. And another objective is up-to-date information of inventory. It is highly required to know the management about the information of the inventory status from time to time to avoid misuse of the inventory, theft of the inventory, and mishandling of the inventory. And the last objective is relieve the management from inventory decisions. See, in large manufacturing concerns, it is not possible to take decisions time to time on inventory. So once the decisions have been taken to manage the inventory, then the management can concentrate on other production issues rather than only the inventory issue. So the management can decide various aspects which are relating to the inventory, then they can fix some standards, and the administrative or ministerial staff can take the decisions within the prescribed limitations. So to relieve the management from inventory decisions, to achieve these objectives, inventory control, scientific inventory control is highly essential. If we see the techniques of the inventory, so to achieve effective inventory control, there are some techniques which have to be applied in appropriate manner. There are 8 techniques. In some organizations, the techniques may be more, whatever that may be. Overall, the techniques which I have mentioned here through this slide will cover all the aspects of the techniques of inventory control. So the number one technique is ABC analysis. Number second technique is setting of various stock levels. Third technique, economic order quantity. Fourth technique, proper purchase procedure. Fifth, proper storage of material and stores records and continuous stock verification, control ratio and review of slow and non-moving items. Now we will discuss each technique in detail. What are the benefits of these techniques? Why these techniques have been initiated for better control of the inventory? Now we see the ABC technique. ABC technique means always better control. This technique is based on the value of the material. If you analyze the materials which are being used in cost of production, we can classify these materials into 3 categories. Already I said this technique is depending upon the value of the material. So this is value-based technique. So if we analyze the materials which are being used, there we can classify it into 3 categories based on the value. Some materials may have high value, some materials may have medium value, some materials may have low value. So the materials which are being used in the process of production are having high value are classified under A category. And the materials value which are used as low, medium value, that is B classification, B quality of materials. Here B quality of materials means not based on the quality, based on the value of the materials. And the materials which are having low quality are classified under C category. What is the purpose of this classification? The purpose of this classification is imposing the effective control measures. If the material is low quality and spending more amount on imposing high control measures, then it is waste of expenditure. So the basic cost accounting concept is that, objective is that, how to minimize the costs. So in the name of minimizing costs, it is not wise to spend more expenses to minimize the cost. Simply it means that to minimize the 10 rupees, it is not wise to spend more than 10 rupees. Therefore, the materials has to be classified on the basis of value. Based on the value, we have to impose the control measures. Here, A quality of materials which are having high value should be imposed a strict control, sophisticated control, vigilance should be more effective. Amount has to be spent more on for the purpose of control. And the second category items, B, medium value of items, we have to spend less amount for imposing controls. And the third category, low value of items which are being used in the cost of productions, so least control measures may be imposed on low quality of materials. If we see the illustration, which the figures have been taken on arbitrary basis, here we have categorized into the materials which are all materials which are being used in the cost production of the product A, B, C.
I think Professor Raju, I would like to interrupt you in between. In fact, what happens that when we have to manufacture the goods, so there are so many parts in the organization which has to be used simultaneously for manufacturing the goods. So in fact, we have to identify the parts which are most valuable, and which are very less in number. And on the other hand, the parts which are very large in number but carry very less amount of value.
That I am coming to explain. So here, second is percentage of total value. Percentage of total value means this is the value which incurs in the process of cost of production. And quantity of the materials which are being used in the process of manufacturing of a product. Now, the A quality of materials which are having high cost, but it is used very low quantity. For example, 10% of quantity of materials which are being used in producing the A product may have high percentage of value, that is 70%. These are arbitrary figures, these are not fixed figures. Sometimes even 5% of quantity may have 80% of the value also. Similarly, B category, 20% of the quantity which is used for producing a product may have 20% of the value. Sometimes it may be 15%, it may be 25% also, or even 10% also. And third category of the materials, the quantity may be 70%, but its value is 10% only. So here, for A category of material, strict control is required. For B category of material, moderate control is enough. For C category of material, simple control is required. That means the amount which the manufacturing concern is going to spend on control measures varies from one kind of raw material or material to another kind of material. It is depending upon its value. This is ABC analysis. Now, coming to the second technique, that is stock levels. Stock levels means, stock means whatever the material the manufacturing concern purchased and keep in the stores for free movement of the material for cost of production. These stock levels will be decided based on certain factors. These are the factors which influences the stock levels are: one, anticipated rate of consumption. Here I will explain later, the stock levels has to be decided as maximum stock level, minimum stock level, reorder level and danger level. Even reorder quantity also we have to, the manufacturing concern has to decide. So to decide these levels, certain factors has to be considered. Those factors are: number one, anticipated rate of consumption. This may be estimated or this may be decided based on the previous experience. This anticipatory rate of consumption means how much material is required to produce the products in a year. That means annual usage of material and amount of capital available. Sometimes the manufacturing concern may not invest more amount on purchasing the material. So based on the financial capacity of the concern, the stock levels has to be decided. This is also one of the factors which influences to decide the stock levels. Then third point is availability of store space. This is also important. If the store space won't permit to purchase the more inventory, then the stock levels are influenced or restricted based on the availability of the storage space. Of course, if the manufacturing concern is in need of to store more quantity of stock, there is no problem to increase the space of the storage. This is, it won't play major role while deciding the stock levels. But the major role plays annual usage, requirement of the material annual usage and amount of the capital involved. And the fourth factor to decide the stock level is storage costs. The storage costs also interdependent on availability, amount of capital available also, because the capital has to be used to meet the storage costs also. Next, fifth factor is procurement period. Procurement period means it is also termed as lead time. The procurement period means when the manufacturing concern orders for supply of material, the time taken from placing the order and procurement of the material. This is the procurement period. And the sixth factor is minimum order quantity imposed by suppliers. Sometimes even though we have decided a particular quantity for reorder or place the order, sometimes that suppliers may impose minimum quantity. For example, if we have decided frequently we use to purchase 100 units of inventory, then suppliers may not accept, they may impose at least if you purchase 200 units, then only we supply the material. In such a case, we have to consider to decide the stock levels this factor, that is the minimum order quantity imposed by the suppliers. Then last but not least factor is risk of normal loss. This is also very very important factor for certain items. The items which are having speed absorptions or quick evaporation, such items, long term storage is not advisable. So to avoid this kind of loss, wastage loss, we have to keep in mind the wastage loss while deciding the stock levels. Now the third, in the second technique, now we have to see what are the stock levels, how it has to be decided. Number one is maximum stock level. See, the stock levels has to be decided to overcome the under stock levels or over stock levels. So one is maximum stock level. Maximum stock level means the level at which the stores will not allow to store the materials. This is the maximum stock level. And the maximum stock level has to be decided to avoid idle working capital or dead working capital or blockage of working capital. So this maximum stock level will be decided based on the factors which we have decided earlier. Those are anticipatory consumption, amount of capital available and storage facility. All these factors are interrelated, and all these factors are useful to consider while deciding the stock levels at various stock levels, not only maximum stock level, at various stock level. All these factors has to be considered, and these factors are interlinked. And the stock levels may be decided based on the mathematical equations. So with the benefit of the operational research and mathematical equations, the manufacturing concern decides the stock levels. The maximum stock level may be decided by using the formula. You see, this is the formula. ROL means reorder level. I will explain about the reorder level later on, plus reorder quantity. I will also explain about the reorder quantity later on. Reorder level plus reorder quantity minus minimum consumption per annum into minimum reorder period. Reorder period means the time which it takes between ordering the material and procurement of the material. The time taken in between the two activities is called reorder period. That means how much period is going to be taken for procurement of the inventory. Next, minimum stock level. Minimum stock level is the level at which the storage will not supply the material for production process. If the stores supply inventory to production department, when it reaches to minimum level, it is a sign of danger signal. If they won't order for procurement of the material before reaching the minimum level, then the manufacturing concern may face flow of material. So the minimum level has to be fixed somewhere. Immediate action has to be taken for procurement of the material. This minimum level has to be decided with the following formula by considering the factors which we have discussed earlier. The formula is reorder level minus normal consumption into normal reorder period. Here, what is normal consumption? Normal consumption is that maximum consumption plus minimum consumption. That means average of maximum consumption and the average consumption of maximum and minimum. It is maximum consumption plus minimum consumption divided by 2. And normal reorder period also, this is the it is also average reorder period. That means maximum reorder period maximum time taken for procurement of the material plus minimum time taken for procurement of the material divided by 2. This is the normal reorder period. Sometimes we may calculate this normal reorder period from the figures which have been given to us, or sometimes the manufacturing concern itself decide the normal consumption period and normal reorder period. In sometimes the normal reorder period may not be the average reorder period. It may variate from time to time based on the various factors. So in the case of normal consumption also, it may not be equal to the average consumption period if it is the quantity is decided by the manufacturing concern. Then next, coming to another level, that is danger level. See, we have discussed a maximum level, stock level, minimum stock level. Danger level is to be fixed somewhere in between the maximum stock level and minimum stock level. The danger stock level is decided just below the minimum stock level. Only reorder level is to be decided in between the minimum maximum stock level and minimum stock level. Danger level is to be decided just somewhere below the minimum stock level. Why this is required? Danger stock level is required. Why? Because already we have discussed before reaching the minimum stock level, the order has to be placed for procurement of the material. When it reaches minimum stock level, the stores should take precautions to release the material under important jobs only, not for routine production. So this danger level is fixed below the minimum stock level to give a more caution to the stores department. At this level, when stock reaches to danger level, emergency purchases, emergency orders to be placed, or persuasion should be done for procuring the material. So for deciding the danger level, the formula, the mathematical formula is by considering the factors which we discussed earlier. Normal consumption, I explained about the normal consumption, it is the average consumption, maximum consumption in a year plus minimum consumption in a year divided by 2 into maximum reorder period under emergency conditions. Now you could understand this maximum reorder period under emergency conditions. The emergency conditions is the indication of reaching the stock level below, falling the stock levels below the minimum stock level. Now coming to the reorder level. So unless we know the reorder levels, it is not possible to decide the minimum stock level, maximum stock level, even danger level also, it is not possible. So reorder level plays a vital role to decide the maximum stock level, minimum stock level and danger level. So now what is this reorder level? The reorder level is the level where purchase of materials has to be initiated. Already I explained, this reorder level is to be decided in between maximum stock level and minimum stock level. And this reorder level involves the quantity of material, how much quantity of material has to be ordered. Here, deciding the quantity of material is a important factor in the reorder to decide the reorder level. It is nothing but a reorder quantity. Reorder level is nothing but a reorder quantity. So here, reorder quantity has to be decided on economical basis. where we can get more benefits to order a particular amount of quantity. Sometimes if we order more quantity of material, then it may lead to wastage of working capital, and transport cost may high, and even storage carrying cost incurs huge carrying cost. Therefore, ideal quantity has to be decided for reordering the material. So at the reorder level, the purchasing orders has to be placed. Now, what is the reorder quantity? This reorder, I already explained, the reorder quantity should be in an economical manner. Economical manner means we have to decide the economic reorder quantity. The economic reorder quantity can be assessed by applying a mathematical equation based on the various factors which I explained earlier. The reorder quantity can be decided by applying this formula. EOQ stands for economic order quantity is equal to 2UO divided by root of I. This U and O and I, these are the words which are used for a particular purpose. In some books, these letters are different. Sometimes AS divided by A can may be used. So here, U means annual usage in units. That means how much material is going to consume for production process, for producing the products in a year. Next, ordering cost per order. Third, I stands for inventory carrying cost of one unit for 1 year. Inventory carrying cost means the costs which are incurred for storing the material or carrying the material till it releases to the production process. So these may be insurance of the godown and staff salary, godown staff salary, and interest on the investment which we spent on material, and other miscellaneous expenses also. So therefore, these three factors has to be considered for calculation of or for arrive the quantity where we have to place the order. This is economic reorder quantity. So for economic to decide the economic reorder quantity, two factors will influence a lot. Number one is annual usage of the material. Number two is inventory carrying cost.
I think Professor Raju, while deciding the reorder quantity, there are two things.
Economic reorder. We call it as an economic order quantity,
as you have explained it very beautifully. So here, in fact, the organization is going to incur two types of cost, that is ordering cost and carrying cost. So sometimes when we are going to take the decision that okay, we should purchase the material in bulk. So on the one hand, we are going to minimize the ordering cost, as we have to give the order once that we are purchasing the material in bulk. But simultaneously, on the other hand, we are going to incur the more carrying cost. Sometimes, say for example, if today the price of the material is say rupees 5 per unit, so the price declining loss is also very important, because maybe in the future that price may decline and today we are going to buy the material against rupees 5 per unit, and in case if in the future the price goes down and it comes to rupees 3 per unit, so buying the material in bulk will again very big problem for the organization, and ultimately the cost of the product will go high, because the organization which will be buying the material time and again, so they'll be purchasing the material against rupees 3 per unit, and that way their cost of production will ultimately be lower as compared to our product.
Yes.
So that way we are going to lose the market and ultimately profit. So while deciding the reorder quantity, we should be very cautious about carrying cost as well as the ordering costs. So there should be a judicious balance between these two. So where the total of carrying cost and ordering cost is minimum, I think that point is a point where we should go for placing the fresh order to the suppliers. That is the minimum point, reorder quantity.
As you said, this is sometimes it is difficult to take the decision to change the economic reorder quantity also. Of course, whatever the stock levels we have discussed so far, these are not a fixed and rigid stock levels.
Yeah.
Time to time, it may change according to the situations.
Yeah.
If the manufacturing concerns increases its production,
yes,
automatically the stock levels are to be changed.
Yes.
That is number one. And number two, as you said, for example, if the material, the price of the material in market fall down,
yes,
then if we purchase bulk of stock more than the reorder quantity, economic reorder quantity,
yes,
that is beneficial, relatively beneficial to the industry. But here we have to consider not only purchasing more than the reorder quantity, we have to consider the storage space.
Exactly.
That and the nature of the material.
Yes, that is also important.
Sometimes, okay, the material fall down 2 rupees.
Yes.
If we keep, we purchase and keep longer time, if the material is in nature of highly evaporative or absorbents,
then again
then
evaporation
is, yes, there is no use. And
yes,
providing the conditions in the storage space to keep less evaporation,
yes,
we have to spend more amount rather than what we are going to
exactly
save also.
Yes.
That's why all these are interrelated factors. These factors are depending upon situation to situation, yes, and conditions to conditions.
And I think, and Professor Raju, one more important thing, technology is also going to play a very major role, because these days the fashion, the taste and demand of the customer is going to be changed very fast.
Hmm.
Say for example, if there is a fashion of wearing jeans and all that, and accordingly if we buy the material for jeans, maybe that after a month or two the fashion of wearing jeans may go, and ultimately we have
sometimes
to
it is a kind of get one, buy one and get one.
Yes.
So another factor is stores records. This stores records are bin card and stores ledger. Bin card is a card which gives this is the specimen bin card. In the specimen bin card, receipts, issues and balance, whenever we receive the material, we enter in the receipts, whenever we issue the material to the manufacturing production departments, we use it to record in this and balance at any point of time. The physical stock verification, this store ledger and bin cards are useful. These are the techniques for effective inventory control.
Thank you, Professor Raju, for presenting the matter so simple and so meticulously, and I do hope that the students might have been benefited a lot, because sometimes when we talk about inventory management, really it's a very crucial decision, deciding about the quantity of the material and deciding about the reorder level, that at where we should start placing a fresh order to the supplier and of what quantity in fact. So these are very crucial decisions, and we should have a judicious balance between these two, so that we can minimize, we can economize the cost of the product, and only then we can survive in the market. So thank you very much, Professor Raju, for delivering such a nice presentation.
Thank you very much.